Greetings, you don't know about Disneyland part 6. Hello viewers, how are you? Welcome to the 6th part of the video, interesting facts about Disneyland. Make sure to check all the other 5 parts of my video. With that said, let's get back to our discussion topic. Number 81. Disneyland Railroad has a secret car dedicated to Lily and Disney that is only open to a select few guests every day. If you want a special experience aboard the Disneyland Railroad, get to the park very early, just as it opens, and ask a cast member to ride the Lily Ballet car, named after Walt Disney's wife. This special car only allows for a few guests to ride every day. The train car is decorated like a Victorian parlor, with plush velvet seats and artifacts from Disney history, including a scrapbook and Disney family photos. Number 82. Every Disney park has at least one Winnie, Walt Disney's term for a landmark that catches your eye immediately. Disney historian Jim Corkes said that the term Winnie or Weenie came from a game Walt used to play with his pet poodles. Dad would go to the refrigerator and pull out two uncooked hot dogs, one for himself and one for the dog. Dame Disney Miller, Walt's youngest daughter, once told Corkes he would play with her, wiggling the hot dog around, and she would go wherever he moved around and was so happy when she finally got her treat. Disneyland's main Winnie is, of course, Sleeping Beauty's castle, but there are other visual focal points designed to draw visitors in throughout the park, like California Adventure's Fun Wheel or Tomorrowland's Spaceship Earth. Number 83. The C-3PO and R2-D2 in Star Tours are real movie props from the Star Wars movies. Disney historian Jim Hill said that George Lucas wanted the Star Tours simulator to look and feel authentic, so he loaned Disneyland real props from the original Star Wars movies. Number 84. A telegraph inside Disneyland's telegraph office, Walt Disney's Disneyland opening day address in Morse code on a loop. The telegraph taps out a Morse code translation of a portion of the speech Walt Disney made on Disneyland's opening day in 1955. To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land. Here age relives fond memories of the past, and here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future.
A special decorated horse on King Arthur's carousel is dedicated to Julie Andrews. Jingles was Walt Disney's favorite carousel horse, and in 2008, the elaborately decorated horse was presented to Julie Andrews as a nod to her classic role in Mary Poppins and to recognize her service as a Disney Parks ambassador. Disney uses a special paint color called No-See M-Green to detract attention from backstage areas or places under construction. Disneyland invented the drape paint color known as Go Away Green or No-See M-Green that's specially designed to draw your eye away from it. The gray-green paint helps camouflage areas of the park that Imagineers don't want to notice. Doritos were invented in Disneyland. Frito-Lay owned a restaurant in Disneyland when the park opened in 1955 called Casa de Fritos. The restaurant came up with a simple way of repurposing stale tortillas that would otherwise be thrown away by flavoring and frying them. After the fried tortilla snacks were a huge success with Disney guests, Frito-Lay transformed Doritos into a national brand. Walt Disney's last ride was the Pirates of the Caribbean. The Pirates of the Caribbean ride was the last ride that Walt Disney himself participated in designing. The ride opened on March 18, 1967, 3 months after Disney passed away from cancer on December 15, 1966. The ride came about before anyone had never dreamed up the idea of the Pirates of the Caribbean film series, and throughout the film you can see references to the famous Disney ride, including the dog with keys in his mouth and the inclusion of the song Yo-ho, a pirate's life for me. The Pirates of the Caribbean ride cost $8 million, which is over half of the $15 million that it cost to build the entire New Orleans Square section. The ride has received some controversy over the past few years. In response, Disney reimagined a few scenes. Most recently, he passed here the controversial action scene was revamped. It's a small world originally debuted at the New York World Fair. The 1964-1965 New York World's Fair was quite an extravaganza and the largest held in the United States. In showcased jetpacks, Belgians, waffles, works from Michelangelo, the Ford Mustang, and a smartphone-like device called the Picture Phone. It was also showcased some amazing attractions produced by Disney and its creative team that would later become Disneyland attractions. The fair, which opened April 22, 1964, featured four attractions produced by Disney and his team, including the counterpiece of the UNICEF Pavilion. It's a Small World, which took guests to more than 100 countries using cutting edge for the time animatronics. Disney also showcased Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln, a live show called The Carousel Theater of Progress that told the story of man's progress, and Ford's Magic Skyway, which took audiences on a journey back in time and was the inspiration for Disney's People Mover, which was a ride from 1967 to 1995. It used to be able to fish in the rivers of America. Once upon a time in Disneyland, you used to be able to fish a small netted portion of the rivers of America, which the Mark Twain riverboat attraction floats down, used to be full of fish to visitors could enjoy their day at Disneyland and catch a fish or two. Guests would grab a fishing pole from a shed on Huckleberry Finn's fishing pier and stand on Tom Sawyer's Island to catch one of the Disneyland catfish. Once they did, they were encouraged to bring their eats to the river bell terrace when it would be chilled until they were ready to go home. However, the attraction proved to be a nuisance. Guests didn't bring their fish into the restaurant and instead opted to carry them around the park or throw them in trash bins or lockers, and it didn't take long for the park to smell fishy. The attraction was shut down just around the park or through the weeks after being opened. Disneyland rented the Rivers America in 2010 and found a bunch of items at the bottom of it, including the strongest one, a computer tower. Items included cell phones and pagers, baby pacifiers, sunglasses, and half of a cannon. There is a bullet hole in the Haunted Mansion. It turns on the spooky Haunted Mansion attraction has a creepy secret of its own. There is a bullet hole in the ballroom. While much speculation surrounds the bullet hole, the legend goes that in 1974, a guest brought a cancelled firearm into the park and fired off multiple rounds. There were at least two rounds shot off, and the first bullet made its way through the ballroom while in the Haunted Mansion and a snowflake on the former ride Adventure through Inner Space. Apparently, he was aiming for the panes of glass that let you see the ghost reflections, and the second was found in the Primeval World diorama on the train. The incident has not surprisingly been kept under wraps by Disney, who has not made a comment about it. The bullet hole was covered by a spider web display that Disney brought an artist in to create. Tony the Tiger is at Disneyland, sort of. You can hear the loud booming voice of Tony the Tiger from the Kellogg's Frosted Flakes brand throughout your experience in Disneyland. The voice, that of the late Thurl Ravenscroft, the original Tony the Tiger, can be heard leading the number Grim Grinning Ghost that plays when you are inside the Haunted Mansion. Ravenscroft can also be heard on any of the Disneyland Railroad trains when he voices the conductor. Plus, he plays Fritz the Parrot and a Polynesian god totem in the enchanted tiki room, and lends his voice to a few of the pirates in the Pirates of the Caribbean attraction. Ravenscroft also performed the iconic song You Are a Mean One, Mr. Grinch from the original 1966 cartoon, along with lending his voice to a number of original Disney films and television programs, including The Aristocrats, The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh, and Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color. Toy Story characters react to And is coming. It is said that some of the most entertaining characters running around the park are those of the Toy Story franchise. That's because it used to be that when a park goer yelled "And is coming" in front of the Toy Story toys, the characters would stop and drop, just like they did in the movie. The Disneyland Toy Story characters are great sports, much like all the others in the park, unless you count Captain Jack Sparrow, who is unlikely to take a photo with you as he stumbles around the park and used to let patrons pose for photos like they were also in Andy's toy collection. Unfortunately, park officials in recent years have made an update that Toy Story characters are no longer allowed to actually drop to the ground, likely due to safety concerns, but the characters still participate in the fun by freezing and or going limp if a park guest shoots "And is coming." Try it out yourself. Get free Disneyland recipes at City Hall. Are you loving that mint julep from the French market so much you want to make it at home? Or did you fall for the corn chowder at Storyteller's Cafe and want to chow down on a bowl in the comfort of your own home? You totally can. At City Hall, you can ask for a variety of recipes for some of Disneyland's favorite culinary delights. Get the secret scenes, screens going on Toy Story Mania. There is more to Toy Story Mania over at Disney California Adventure than meets the eye. In such of the game segments, there are special things you can do that will earn you more points.
When you aim or hit certain creatures, characters, or items when playing Toy Story Midway Mania, new scoring opportunities and screens will appear. These will help you beat out the competition while getting the most points. For example, in Rex and Trixie's Dino Darts, if you hit all five of the lava-like balloons coming out of the volcano, a baby of Willems worth 500 points each will erupt. Number 96. Pirates of the Caribbean was almost a museum, not a ride. We all know Pirates of the Caribbean today as a boat ride that takes you underground and through a series of pirate-themed scenes played out by impressive animatronics. But it was not always that way. The original concept of the Pirates of the Caribbean ride, thought up something in the 1950s, was going to be a walk-through wax museum, like Madame Tussauds, but with pirates. The Pirates of the Caribbean wax museum was supposed to see guests walking through the figurines underneath New Orleans Square. However, the It's a Small World and Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln animatronic exhibits were such big hits at the 1964 World's Fair in New York City that the Wax Museum idea was thrown out and a new, more interactive exhibit was put together. While Walt Disney did not get a chance to see the ride fully operating because he passed away only months before its opening on March 18, 1967, the Imagineers working on the project pushed Walt through on a dolly at the same speed a boat would have gone through so he could experience it. Number 97. There's a super old tree. It's true that Disney has made history in so many ways, but when Disneyland was created, they did not realize they would include a silver of the world that has been around for millions of years. Want to see what we are talking about? Find your way to Frontierland, where you'll see the remains of a petrified tree that's said to be 55 to 70 million years old. Legend has it, Walt purchased this tree that once stood at 200 feet from the Pike Forest fossil beds and had it sent to California. A year later, Walt's wife Lillian said it was too large for their mantle at home, so she donated it to Disneyland. Number 98. You can try the goat trick. If your favorite part of the theme park is the rides, thrill seekers will enjoy the challenge of the goat trick when they ride Big Thunder Mountain Railroad at Disneyland. thanks to G-forces and the condition of your inner ear. You can make yourself feel like you are swirling if you follow a few rules. Wait in line so you can snag a seat in the black row of the last car. Then look out for the goat after you get pulled up a hill for the second time. He will be holding a stick of dynamite in his mouth, so you can't miss them. Then fix your eyes on him and turn your head to keep looking at him until the very last second. That's it.
You can trade pins with cast members. In addition to those Mickey or Minnie Mouse ears you have to invest in once you enter the park, make sure you pick up a Disneyland pin too. They give you the unique opportunity to trade as you venture through the park. Look for a Disneyland cast member that's sporting a bunch of trading pins and approach them for a swap. They usually sport limited edition pins or ones that are difficult to source elsewhere, giving you the chance to own something unordinary. Just make sure to ask before you touch, because you know manners. Chat with someone back in time at Starbucks. There is a Starbucks at Disneyland on Main Street. It is California, after all. While you fill up on your Java fix, search for the old-fashioned telephones that are right when you walk inside. They might seem decorative, but there is more to them than you realize. Pick up the receivers and listen, and you will hear all sort of town gossip. Since in the olden days, many households shared the same line. Go on an adventure to find the little man of Disneyland. D23, the official Disney fan club, has written for Walt Disney and his Imagineers to design, build, and open Disneyland Park 60 years ago. Took hurdles of imagination, tons of creative courage, and a wee bit of luck, so it couldn't hurt to have a leprechaun on hand. A whimsical story about just such an Irish elf is one of the best kept secrets surrounding the creation of Walt Disney Magic Kingdom. Fans of his fanciful little fellow have been fascinated with him and his unique status as a resident of the magical park. In fact, some who have read his tale have been searching for his mysterious house ever since. This little leprechaun is known as the Little Man of Disneyland, and his house is actually hidden in Adventureland, near the Indiana Jones Adventure attraction. If you look closely at the roots of one of the trees, you should see the little house. Grab the apple at Snow White's Scary Adventure. In the queue for Snow White's Scary Adventure, you will see a golden poison apple. Reach and touch it. If you dare, when you do, you will realize the trigger, which will allow the evil queen's laughter and thunder to be heard. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check all the other 5 parts of the series. Also wait for the upcoming parts. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button below, and please don't forget to share this video with your friends.